Only my dog.
Boom! Sunny! Happy! Also!
I'm ready! Ready!
Okay, so
I did not choose the type 1 diabetic life.
Get in the pool, doggies.
I won't say it, no, no.
See, Molly?
Okay, I won't say I'm not in love.
Yeah, you are, girl.
No, I'm not.
On the chorus.
Goodbye.
Hey guys, I'm currently sitting in a church parking lot that's across the street from a Rite Aid because I started filming a video to talk about my week, and then a bunch of people were waiting at a stoplight and I had to stop because it looked really weird. I'm still a little self-conscious about videotaping myself for my vlogs because people keep thinking, I guess, that I'm conceited or something of that nature, or they think that I'm weird. I went to Rite Aid to get something that was considered witch hazel slash astringent. Typically I don't get this brand. This is Dickinson's, but typically I get Seabreeze because it works for my face. And then I was coming out of Rite Aid and I started feeling really low. My blood sugar felt like it was really low, so I decided to pull out of the parking lot and into a church parking lot where it wasn't so busy so that I didn't take anybody's parking space, because that parking lot for Rite Aid is really small and there's nobody in this parking lot, so I figured it's fine. And it was literally out the back entrance and across the street, and it was fine. So now I ate some Swedish fish. I'm good, I think. I'm a little shaky. Anyways, back to my week. This week has been really interesting. Last week was all, you know, drowsy and dreary and gross because it was raining, and I was depressed, I'm not gonna lie. It was a bad week. It was a really, really bad week. And this week started off about the same way. Monday was a little off. Tuesday was really nice. It ended on a really nice note. I went to my meeting and it was really nice. Today was pretty good too. And then tomorrow is Thursday, and Friday we don't have school. So I'm looking forward to tomorrow basically being a Friday for me. It's really nice. And then on Tuesday, I turned in my money for Justin's, which is the graduation company, I guess, whatever it is. And I got this shirt and then a gray shirt that looks kind of like this but not the same. And then I got my tassel and a bag. And guys, I about cried because it's my senior year of high school. It's been 12 years and I'm about ready to be out. And I can't formulate the words. There are no fathomable words for how I feel about graduating. I mean, I'm ecstatic. I am overjoyed. I am ready, but I'm also not ready. I'm very sad, and I'm a little angry that, you know, 18 years of my life have gone by this fast and without warning. And it's a little intimidating to think that 18 years can go by in the flash of your eye and you didn't even realize it. And to think that in, you know, twice my lifetime, in another 18 years, I'll be 32. 32. And I could have a family, I could have kids, you know, I could be dead. You know, this whole world could be gone. I'm really thinking about all these things, and I can't stop. I can't get my mind to stop thinking about them, and about how everything seems to be changing all of a sudden, and how there are all these responsibilities about senior year and regular life. You know, living as an adult. That's crazy to me, to think that in less than a year, I will be an adult. Not even half a year, I will be 18. I will be legally considered an adult. Not that I'm gonna be an adult. I mean, we all know I'm still gonna be a child at heart and everything else, so. It's just a little crazy. Yeah, so I feel kinda a little bit like I'm suffocating. Like I'm always anxious all the time, and last week just got the best of me. And I thank God for the great friends that I've got that have stuck by me through it, because last week was not a fun time to be around me. I was not fun. I hardly talked, I barely laughed, you know, I barely smiled at all. And I was definitely not this yellow, bright, happy person that people typically see me as. And I don't think that a lot of people have seen that side of me. And I think it's because last year I did what I considered a pretty good job of hiding how I really felt, and this year it's just not possible because there's just so much stuff going on, and I don't think that people realize that all of this stuff that's going on, you know, the senior year and growing up and leaving what I've known for 12 years of my life, I don't think that they realize just how much that means to me. I mean, I've gotten this far in my life with all these different things that have come in my way, and I've actually made it, despite the fact that half of the times I just wanted to turn around and stop. I wanted silence to ensue. I wanted to stop being Molly. I wanted to stop living half of these times when I felt like, you know, change is coming, what am I gonna do? I didn't want to face it. I wanted to run from it. And yet here I am, you know, my senior year of high school, living every single day, one day at a time, but then thinking about the future. I can imagine a future.
Pumpkin!
Gosh! Oh my gosh! What the heck? This is why people with curly hair do not brush their hair. That's what. Look at this. Look at this crazy mess of a hair.
Can you guess who these characters are? Two blue feather boas, two long sleeve red shirts. Can you guess who we're gonna be? I'm gonna give you a minute. No? Okay, thing one and thing two. But with our own twist, we're gonna put pretzel one and pretzel two on the shirts instead, because that's an inside joke of ours. So, that's that. Also, I think I met the only person in human existence, at least in the United States, that when I said thing one and thing two, she had no idea who I was talking about. None. How do you not know who thing one and thing two are? Have you not read Dr. Seuss? And if you haven't, I mean, like, come on, Cat in the Hat. It's everywhere. What have you been kept in a cave your whole life? I'm sorry, that's kind of rude. But still, thing one and thing two. Jeez. Anyway. It's Friday. I don't have school today. It's a professional day for us here in Wicomico County, so I'm just basically driving around, doing things, getting ready for next week, which is Spirit Week. Day one, Monday, is Messy Mix Match Monday, which means that I have to find every single pattern that I have in my closet and put it to good use. Day two is Twinning Tuesday. That's what I'm gonna be thing one, pretzel one with my pretzel two, Roxanne. Day three is Unity Orange Wednesday. It's for bullying prevention. It's bullying prevention month, so We're gonna wear orange to show our support. I got an orange shirt for that too when I was in there, so that's another reason why my cost went up to $30. And then, what day am I at? Thursday is Throwback Thursday. I need to get stuff for that. So I need to go to Walmart and quick get stuff for Throwback Thursday. I bought a yellow shirt, so I might do something with that. And then Friday is Class Color Friday. And let me tell you, I am so excited because we're black this year. Okay, we wear black this year, all black. I'm very excited. Oh man, I should probably go back in Hobby Lobby and get some more stuff for Black Friday. Anyways, I might or might not talk to you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow's gonna be a busy day. And if I don't, this is me signing out. Bye guys.
It's okay, you're in love, Mom.
I'm not in love, you freak.
Annie, he's so loud. Do you want to see you in love with me?